Hey there, Joseph Kern, instructional designer at Emporia State University. This video we're going to talk about auras in Aurasma. And before I do, you want to make sure you go to your account management and make sure you have these checked, because there are cool things that aren't available to you by default, but they're free, and just by checking this box, you get to do them. And this is available in the PDF that I showed earlier in this guide. Actually, it's the same PDF, basically, but they jump you right to the fancy part where you're looking at the advanced actions. So ways you can do extra 3D stuff and ways that you can control what happens when you tap on an object or add a time delay or other fancy things. There's a really good video about how you can do multiple overlays on the same image, and this guy uses like a poster of planets, and so tapping on each planet can take you somewhere, so check that video out. But the really nice thing is they give examples of how to set something up to occur the way you want it to. They have extensive outlines of step one, step two. They have complex diagrams showing how you can make it happen. So they really want you to do cool stuff with their app, which is, again, free and very nice of them. So check that out if you want to get crazy with it. Let's also look at the settings for the auras that I showed at the beginning of the intro video. I started with a grafting video, and these are displayed in alphabetical order rather than how they were added. And the video will automatically play off to the side here, but we can see what the details are, so I can edit those at any point. I can add in time restrictions, so I can say only, during this week will this aura actually work. I have one overlay, which is the video, and when I tap it, it will play full screen. If I double tap it, it will go to the YouTube location where it actually came from. If we look at the next one, it was another grafting video. And it had the same setting, so tapping makes it go full screen, double tapping takes it to YouTube to watch it there. It would probably be a good idea for your channel to always have those same options with the video, so that way students aren't guessing. The next one was it sent them to a website about pruning. Because this is a website, it will show the first page of it when it initially loads, but this is a multi-page PDF, so you probably want to set it so that students can go access the rest of it. So this is set in order that they can tap it once, and it will load the URL of that PDF, and they can scroll through it there. And again, have those settings standardized just by doing the same thing the same way every time, and your students will be able to follow it a lot better. All right, next we have the 3D box. Now, I got this just off the Aurasma website. It was able to download just so you had a sample image. The PDF of customer guidelines has all the information about the types of 3D objects, the file types you can put into these. The hard thing is tracking them down. I haven't really found a great place to easily bring in a whole bunch of these. If you're making your auras from the iPad app, it has a bunch of those already built into it, but they're kind of just weird, silly things. So really, if anybody finds a good place to put maybe more relevant 3D models or good ways to make them, put those in the comments here on this video so that way everybody else can find them. And there was the tree aura that we had where, looking at the overlay, it was just this image of a tree. There was no background to it. The background became whatever I was videoing with my iPad. The way it was set up was that originally just the image popped up on top of the book. I tapped it, and then it went full screen with active camera. And so in that case, now I'm videoing the world, and then it lays it over just whatever I've videoed. Now, if you find an image that you want to do that way, but you don't know how to get rid of the background, just go to YouTube and say remove image background, and you'll find a whole bunch of ways to do it with Photoshop or other things, Publisher, there are ways to do this. So that's the magic behind the auras that I showed in the intro video. Now looking in the auras, the 3D box is in here twice, so you can put the same aura on two different trigger images. So it happens when I look at this image, and it happens when I look at this image. So different options there. You could also duplicate your aura. So that's one thing, is so you can play around with it without screwing up the original. And this is also where you edit or delete them. If, let's say I wanted to delete this trigger image in my trigger images, if I told it to delete, it's not available to me. I would have to delete the aura first, which is really nice, so that way you don't have any trigger images trying to go somewhere, or an aura trying to happen when the trigger image is lost. So it helps bundle things together, so you're not left with orphan pieces out there. But let's add in our aura. We wanted this to be the spraying aura. We want to pick the trigger image of spraying. We want to put this in our channel for that book. We add in the overlay. And so this is that image that I wanted to show. Oh, I should probably tap on this and it's going to take me somewhere. Now I add in the action, because right now, if I just scan this, it's just going to pop up the play button on top of the image, and that's not very exciting. So when I tap that play button, I want it to do any one of these. I'm just going to pick load a URL because I'm going to send them to my video. So I can copy that. Now there are options in YouTube where you can tell it to copy or start the video at a certain point. That doesn't work for Aurasma. So even if you tell it to start at 2 minutes and 50 seconds, it'll just start at the beginning. Alright, make sure when you paste, you highlight that also, because otherwise you'll have two HTTPs and it won't work. So let's paste that in here. Let's check that we only have one HTTP. And we save. So now with my iPad, I can scan the image, and I get that image to pop up. Now if it were just the image, that's what it would look like. So when I tap it once, it takes me to YouTube where I can now see this video happening. So as far as students navigating this, if you want them to go to 2 minutes and 50 seconds in it, maybe you could include that in the trigger image. So you can say tap here and scroll forward to 250. Just an option. So that's how to make an aura with Aurasma Studio, bring some augmented reality and spice up, in this case, your really, really, really old textbook or a poster or pretty much, again, anything you want to have your students scan, see what you can get to pop up.